Well, hi. Come on in here and let's talk about insulation. All right, folks. So we have the opportunity to look at different types of insulation. First type we have is called fiberglass. Fiberglass is actually little tiny glass thread fibers. And it's very itchy. I do not like working with it. I like the benefits of it. I do not like working with it. That is why I have this sweet getup on, so that I don't get it on my clothes. I take it home and then I get itchy. When I work with it, I will wear a bandana and gloves, glasses. That way I'm not breathing that in, not getting that in my between my fingers and on my hands and making me itchy. And I'm not getting that breathe in to my lungs to make them scratchy, make my throat scratchy, make my sinuses hurt. So yeah, I'm not a big fan of working with fiberglass, but I do like the benefits of it. It's a good insulating product. It creates a nice dead air space. It insulates well. So there's also this beautiful stuff. It's called cellulose. And cellulose, I'm not sure if it is still made that way, but it used to be made with like ground up newspaper and paper fibers. And it is a decent insulation. One thing about this stuff, if you blow it in the attic, you can have a blown in or you can have rolled stuff. We have some fiberglass bats right here. This fiberglass, you can blow it in your attic, but it is prone to being moved by wind. So if you have an attic like this, and you blow in the insulation like that, the cellulose doesn't really move. It's heavy enough that it pretty much stays put. The fiberglass can actually kind of move. So if you want the best of both worlds, you can blow in some fiberglass, create a nice layer down there, then you can blow in the cellulose on top. So fiberglass and then cellulose, or you can just blow either one in. They're both going to insulate fairly well. So today we are going to insulate with fiberglass these cavities here. We're not going to do all of them, but we are going to do some of them. They all need to be insulated, but I do have to run some wires in this wall, so I won't do all of them. Alright guys, I'm getting ready to cut this insulation. I got my pretty sweet bibs on, my coveralls actually. Got my gloves, glasses, got my super cool hat, and my bandana. So, what you want to do is figure out your stud space. And then this stuff is what they call friction fit. And there's other stuff that has paper on it with little stapling flanges called craft face. And you can staple the craft face. You can fold those tabs over and staple it to the stud. But it's more for consistent stud spaces. This in here is not consistent. So we're gonna use friction fit. I'll cut it so it's a little bit tight and it'll fit in those spaces. So I'm going to cut this by taking my marker. I'm going to mark out my measurement. I'm going to take my utility knife and I'm going to lay a board on my line that I'm going to cut. I'm going to set a knee on it. And that squashes it down, so that way when I cut it, it makes a nice cut. Again, set my knee on it, get my utility knife, I can take it and push it in this wall. I'm gonna cut it off. And this is what we call friction fit. And the reason we do that, the reason we call it friction fit is because just by the friction of the width, it holds itself in place. So we're gonna go ahead and do the rest of this wall, and then we'll put plastic over it because it needs a vapor barrier. It needs a layer where it's not gonna let moisture in or out. And so, the craft based insulation, you don't have to put an extra moisture or a vapor barrier there. That paper is the vapor barrier. But with the friction fit, you have to put an extra vapor barrier. I have this wall as insulated, except for this spot, as I'm going to insulate it right now because I'm going to run some wires in here. I don't want to have to take that insulation all back out. But you can see there's a lot of dust and particles swirling in the air. Really important when you work with insulation, gloves, glasses, some sort of stop that limits that amount of stuff you can breathe in. So I really do not like installing insulation. It's one of my least favorite things. It's about as fun as a sharp stick in the eye. So usually when I get done, I feel great. I feel like dancing or something. Hey, thanks for watching the video. Thanks so much for the view. Remember, folks, to work hard because hard work is its own reward. Try to better yourself today. Make yourself better today than you were yesterday. Thanks for watching.